RIM116 being launched from USS New Orleans in 2013. The RIM116 is in service on several American and 30 German warships. All new German Navy warships will be equipped with the RAM, such as the new Braunschweig-class corvettes, which will mount two RAM launchers per ship. The Greek Navy has equipped the new Super Vito-class fast attack craft with the RAM. South Korea has signed licensed production contracts for their Navy's KDX Roman II, KDX Roman III, and Docto-class amphibious assault ships. The RIM116 Rolling Airframe Missile, RAM, refers to a lightweight, quick reaction, fire and forget missile. It was designed to destroy anti-ship cruise missiles and asymmetric air and surface threats. The RIM116 RAM was developed as a collaboration project between the U. Currently there are two RIM116 configurations, namely Block 1A, RIM116B, and Block 2, RIM116C. Block 1A is nearly finished with full rate production. Features. The RIM116 RAM is designed as a high firepower, low cost, self-defense system against anti-ship cruise missiles and other asymmetric threats. For all versions of the missile, there is no shipboard support required, i.e., no illuminators after missile launch. The original Block Zero design was based upon the infra-red seeker of the Stinger missile and the warhead, rocket motor, and fuse from the Sidewinder missile. The Block Zero configuration uses radio frequency, RF for midcourse guidance and transitions to infrared, IR guidance for terminal engagement. The Block 1A incorporates the added capability of autonomous IR all-the-way guidance, thus countering advanced anti-ship cruise missiles that do not employ onboard radar seekers. The Block 2 missile provides kinematic and guidance improvements for countering maneuvering and low probability of intercept threats to regain battle space. It features a control section upgrade, 4 canards vs. 2 for Block 1A, a propulsion section upgrade, a larger composite case rocket motor, and an evolved radio frequency ERF receiver. RAM Block 2 initial operating capability, IOC, was achieved in May 2015. Approval for full rate production was received in November 2018. Background. The RIM116 RAM is a cooperative development, production, and in-service program between the U.S. and German governments. The RIM116 RAM is fully operational in the U.S., German, and Allied navies, including South Korea, Greece, Egypt, UAE, Turkey, and Japan, with over 5,000 missiles produced throughout the life of the program. RAM is deployed worldwide via the MK-49 RAM Guided Missile Launching System, GMLS, and the MK-15 Mod 32 Serum Plosin Weapons System. Sits on more than 100 ships ranging from fast patrol boats to aircraft carriers, and is being installed on a majority of new USN ship classes, MA-6, CVN-78, NFFG-X. The RIM116 RAM is also deployed on the LCS ship class utilizing MK-15 Mod 31 Serum SIWS and DDG-64/71/75/78 utilizing MK-15 Mod 33 Serum SIWS. Meanwhile, the RAM Block 2 configuration is currently in low-rate initial production and undergoing developmental and operational testing. In regard to the development, the RIM116 was developed by General Dynamics Pomona and Valley Systems Divisions under a July 1976 agreement with Denmark and West Germany. The General Dynamics Missile Company, which is today part of Raytheon, at that time, Denmark, withdrew from the program while the U.S. Navy joined in as the major partner. The MK-49 launcher was evaluated on board the destroyer USS David R. Ray in the late 1980s. The first 30 missiles were manufactured in F-85 and went into service on 14 November 1992 on board USS Peleliu. If we take a closer look at the features, the RIM116 RAM is designed as a high firepower, low cost, self-defense system against anti-ship cruise missiles and other asymmetric threats. The RIM116 RAM is fully in service with the U.S., German, and Allied navies, including South Korea, Greece, Egypt, UAE, Turkey, and Japan, with approximately 5,000 missiles produced throughout the life of the program. As its name indicates, RAM rolls as it flies. The missile needs to roll during flight because the RF tracking system uses a 2-antenna interferometer to measure phase interference of the electromagnetic wave in one plane only. The rolling interferometer allows the antennas to look at all planes of incoming energy. Moving on further, we will identify some variants of this missile, including first, the Block Zero, which is the original version of the missile. It was based on the AIM-9 Sidewinder air-to-air missile, whose rocket motor, fuse, and warhead were used. Block Zero missiles were built to initially home in on radiation emitted from a target, such as the active radar of an incoming anti-ship missile, switching to an infrared seeker derived from that of the FIM-92 Stinger missile for terminal guidance. In test firings, the Block Zero missiles achieved hit rates of over 95%. Moreover, the Block 1, which is known as RIM-116B, it is a more advanced variant of the RAM missile that adds an overall infrared-only guidance system that allows it to intercept missiles that are not emitting any radar signals. The Block Zero's radar homing capabilities have been retained, followed by the Block 2 variant. It is an upgraded version of the RAM missile aimed at more effectively countering more maneuverable anti-ship missiles. On 8 May 2007, the U.S. Navy granted Raytheon Missile Systems a $105 million development contract, which was expected to be completed by December 2010. LRIP began in 2012. 51 missiles were initially requested. On 22 October 2012, the RAM Block 2 completed its third guided test vehicle flight, firing two missiles in a salvo and directly striking the target. This test is intended to evaluate the system's command and control capabilities, kinematic performance, guidance system, and airframe capabilities. Moreover, Raytheon was expected to deliver 25 of Block 2 missiles during the program's integrated testing phase. The Block 2 RAM was delivered to the U.S. Navy in August 2014, with precisely 502 missiles to be acquired from 2015 to 2019. Initial operational capability, IOC, for the Block 2 RAM was achieved on 15 May 2015. The next one is HAZ mode. In 1998, a memorandum of understanding was signed by the Defense Departments of Germany and the United States to enhance the system so that it could also engage the so-called HAZ helicopter, aircraft, and surface targets. As developed, the HAZ upgrade just required software modifications that can be deployed to all Block 1 RAM missiles. The last one is SIRIM weapon system. The SIRIM combines the radar and electro-optical system of the Phalanx SIUS MK-15 Block 1B CRDC with an 11-cell RAM launcher to create an autonomous system, one which does not need any external information to engage threats. Similar to the Phalanx, SIRIM can be installed to any class of ship. The first SIRIM system was delivered in 2008 to be installed on USS Independence. As of December 2013, one SIRIM is fitted to each Independence-class vessel. Moreover, the Navy announced in late 2014 that the SIRIM would be installed on the Small Surface Combat and LCS follow-on ships. Beginning in November 2015, the Navy will complete installation of a SIRIM on the first of four Arleigh Burke-class destroyers patrolling within the U.S. 6th Fleet. In addition, the SIRIM will also equip the Royal Saudi Navy's Multi-Mission Surface Combat MMSE based on the Freedom-class littoral combat ships. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.